Besides, immense power is acquired by assuring yourself in your secret reveries that you were born to control things. He continues, his voice soft. Do you feel that you have immense power? Control freak? I employ over 40,000 people, Miss Steele. That gives me a certain sense of responsibility. Power, if you will. If I were to decide I was no longer interested in the telecommunications business and sell, 20,000 people would struggle to make their mortgage payments after a month or so.
My mouth drops open. I am staggered by his lack of humility. Don't you have a board to answer to? I ask, disgusted.
I own my company. I don't have to answer to a board.
He raises an eyebrow at me. Of course, I would know this if I had done some research, but holy crap, he's arrogant. I change tack. And do you have any interests outside your work?
I have varied interests, Miss Steele.
A ghost of a smile touches his lips.
Very varied.
And for some reason, I'm confounded and heated by his steady gaze. His eyes are alight with some wicked thought. But if you work so hard, what do you do to chill out?
Chill out?
It's a mystery to me. The game commences for the usual fee, plus expenses, confidential information. It's in a diary. This is my investigation. It's not a public inquiry.
He smiles, revealing perfect white teeth. I stop breathing. He really is beautiful. No one should be this good looking.
Well, to chill out, as you put it, I sail, I fly, I indulge in various physical pursuits.
He shifts in his chair.
I'm a very wealthy man, Miss Steele, and I have expensive and absorbing hobbies.
I glance quickly at Kate's questions, wanting to get off this subject. You invest in manufacturing. Why specifically? I ask. Why does he make me so uncomfortable?
I like to build things. I like to know how things work, what makes things tick, how to construct and deconstruct. And I have a love of ships. What can I say?
That sounds like your heart talking rather than logic and facts. His mouth quirks up and he stares appraisingly at me.
Possibly, though there are people who'd say I don't have a heart.
Why would they say that?
Because they know me well.
His lip curls in a wry smile. Would your friends say you're easy to get to know? And I regret the question as soon as I say it. It's not on Kate's list.
I'm a very private person, Miss Steele. I go a long way to protect my privacy. I don't often give interviews.
Why did you agree to do this one?
Because I'm a benefactor of the university. And for all intents and purposes, I couldn't get Miss Kavanaugh off my back. She badgered and badgered my PR people, and I admire that kind of tenacity. I know how tenacious Kate can be. That's why I'm sitting here squirming uncomfortably under his penetrating gaze when I should be studying for my exams. You also invest in farming technologies. Why are you interested in that area?
We can't eat money, Miss Steele. And there are too many people on this planet who don't have enough to eat.
That sounds very philanthropic. Is it something you feel passionately about? Feeding the world's poor? He shrugs noncommittally.
It's shrewd business, he murmurs.
Though I think he's being disingenuous. It doesn't make sense. Feeding the world's poor? I can't see the financial benefit of this, only the virtue of the ideal. I glance at the next question, confused by his attitude. Do you have a philosophy? If so, what is it?
I don't have a philosophy as such. Maybe a guiding principle. Carnegie's. A man who acquires the ability to take full possession of his own mind may take possession of anything else to which he is justly entitled. I'm very singular, driven. I like control of myself and those around me.
So you want to possess things? You are a control freak.
I want to deserve to possess them. But yes, bottom line, I do.
You sound like the ultimate consumer.
I am.
He smiles, but the smile doesn't touch his eyes. Again, this is at odds with someone who wants to feed the world, so I can't help thinking that we're talking about something else. But I'm mystified as to what it is.